some reason, because it doesn't have that strong art grounding in the business side, the voices in the game industry are always men. Almost always men. What men make, they always make games about killing them. You know? I mean, there's some exceptions of Minecraft that came up out of nowhere.
Yeah.
You know? But,
yeah. All the kids that go to the game is that's great. So it's just sports analysis creation.
Yeah, nobody would in the game business would be mentioned at the hardest time. I suppose there is something to be said for, you know, women programming a lot. Anyway, I would just recommend qualitative experience. Go to the art gallery. Go travel. You know, meet people. Go to parties. That kind of thing. Anyway.
I'd also be involved in pretty much, if you're interested in going to these IGD meetings, I inquire you to check it out on their Facebook page. Or their social part of their website or social media pages. Because there's some good events that will be happening soon, I think, in the fall. So,
you know what else is a good exercise if you want to be a game designer? Design a board game.
Yeah, there's board.
And try role-playing games, not role-playing games where the focus is on like
D&D.
Yeah, but I've tried role-playing games where you actually role-play a character. You know, like you're an elf and you have to, okay, I walk up, you know Stephen Colbert, he Dungeons and Dragons gave him the taste of performing. Because when you play Dungeons and Dragons, you can play it like an undercurrent, but you can also play it like an actor.
And anything can happen.
Yes.
So much like a technical improvements on over like recent decades, but this one doesn't really like focus on like hardware specifications and like software specifications, but what they're trying to do this generation is they're like trying to like harness the system's like capabilities of like what it can do, like I mean they're adding on to like the hardware that's like already recent enough. Like, I mean, like, especially if you look at PS4, you'll look at like, real-time motion and all that, and you'll look at, like, faster frame rates, but, I mean, like, it's almost, like, the exact same resolution as PS3, basically. And since we apply to the Wii U, except there isn't, like, a bigger, like, second screen that can be used for, like, so, like, almost kind of, like, as a DS mixed up an NES controller and the actual Wii device itself. I mean, they're trying to find, like, that's a great thing. I mean, we don't need just like graphical and auditory improvements, but to come up with new inventions too.
All I'm saying is I came to business conferences and the way the business people look at games is you are cattle to them. Your time and attention, they're trying to farm you. They're trying to hook you and addict you, literally.
Yeah,
it's really, if you're autistic and you're a gamer, it's so tempting to just implode into gaming. And soon you realize your entire world
doesn't work.
Self-referential inside games. You play games where you're walking around, but you've never gone camping out in the real woods. You've never, you know.
Because it's like a simulation of some sort.
Yes.
But you're
experience. You have a life, and then from drawing your experience, like spy stories were written by guys who were spies. You know, some of the best spy novels.
I don't know. I can't find Flash games on Mac.
Requires
it's not Windows.
Always be in the
Mac
studio all the time.
Yeah.
What can you draw?
Especially like during the studio as well.
No.
Yeah. It's also a bad way in making games as well, to the point where it stresses the shit out of everyone. Mm-hmm. And basically pretty much you get a rushed out product. No one's gonna play it, and we've pretty much had a few good examples over the recent past few years as well. And it's destroying the industry slowly, to the point where we could face a second industry crash. Remember the first crash? During the ET days?
80s?
ET.
Yeah. Why are you never facing another crash?
The Atari 600, like they've made like ET the movie game.
Right.
Pretty much after that game was released, the whole industry crashed for a short time.
Because it was so hyped and they rushed it out in like 4 weeks and it sucked.
And the problem is it was during that console era, it was too generic. 8-bit was just too generic. So pretty much in the middle.
Like
ET,
it's
so much. Yeah. And people were bored of that. No one wanted to play like anything else for a while until Nintendo's knocked on the door and said, "Hey, here's Super Mario, here's Donkey Kong, here's Rob the Robot."
And even then, people wouldn't buy the system at the time.
Yeah,
I mean, like, it's all about, like, how the game's ideas has developed from 1982 and 1983, but also replay value, because, like, if you think about it, the video game crash and all that happened because of ET, but also because a lot of producers have been kind of cranking out, like, the same gameplay ideas. I mean, sure, they branded as different names and, like, different settings and all that, but, like, the replay value was pretty much just, like, a conventional arcade game. It wasn't really sophisticated until like around like 1986 or 1987 when they started releasing brawlers such as Double Dragon, shooters such as Sidearms, platformers such as Bionic Commando. Like, you know, like, you know, like, what talking about less than
the baby.
Everybody? Tim's
are you comfortable with the label autistic? I'm high functioning autistic.
I honestly don't care either way, Asperger's, whatever you want to call it. No, I just wish people would stop having preconceived notions. All the time. But I think people are getting a little bit more, what's the word? A little bit more open.
Yes.
Employers not necessarily so much, but I think in the general public, I think I'm getting more and more comfortable talking about my autism.
Yeah, sure. Then you say you're autistic. It's comfortable.
Oh, I saw it.
That's some of the theme of today's inviting everybody up into these boxes and stuff.
Okay, what I'm saying is, you see, always have to look at race. That's something to
there's a reason for why autism has survived this long.
Right.
I love neurotypicals. Autistic people are prophets. They see patterns. They see things like wizards. You need that. There's a reason why.